Aerophagy is the medical term used for excessive and repeated air deglutition. All people inhale a certain amount of air when they talk, eat, speak or laugh. But those people with aerophagia swallow excess air. Inhale so much air that has your abdomen down and can lead to rot frequently. And disturbs your stomach producing other symptoms and gases. So if you are interested in this subject as well as another on otolaryngology, consider subscribing to our channel. Activate the bell because otherwise YouTube will not recommend new content for you. So the effect called aerophagy is nothing more than the air going towards the stomach. Instead of going exclusively to the lung, which would be ideal. It is frequent, it is associated with any type of food. Especially when someone eats very fast. So those people who have a habit of eating fast without chewing so much. Besides taking food, maybe taking air along with it. And taking air in your gastrointestinal tract causing all the symptoms of aerophagia. But in the special case of CPAP, what happens? CPAP sends air under pressure to clear the pharynx that is collapsing and causing apnea. So what happens? You look at this model here, the air will pass and go towards the trachea to reach the lung. If the air is in excess, if you are having a greater pressure than what you can tolerate, or excessive pressure here, the air besides passing through this path of the trachea here. Besides passing through the trachea, it will also pass back here in the esophagus. Patients who have excessive pressure from CPAP, they may have the air passing through the correct path, or taking a second way there, as if the path was wrong and went to the esophagus. And then the esophagus goes to the entire gastrointestinal tract, which is esophagus, stomach. And then it will go out there through the intestine, the thin intestine, the thick intestine, and can cause all those discomforts that we already talked about. So what do these automatic devices do? They have a pressure window that varies on that and they try to throw your ideal pressure. But it's not always so reliable, so accurate. Sometimes it thinks you need a pressure of X, a pressure of 10, and it throws 12. This excess pressure goes to another path and will cause aerophagia. So what do we do? We use the device in our favor. Let's adjust the device. So if you are using a very high and unnecessary pressure, you need to solve your apnea, for example, a pressure of 8, 9, 10. Or a window between 8 and 10 and you're playing their 12, 14, 16 pressure. All this excess pressure, it makes it easier for you to cause aerophagia. So you have to make a fine adjustment of the device. And this can be done by your doctor or by the team of technicians responsible for the company that is adjusting the device. Another problem that causes aerophagy is when you have your nose congested. So if you have a flu or have an allergic rhinitis, exacerbated nasal congestion for any reason, and you're using the nose siphon on top, what do you do? You naturally seek air, so if you're using the siphon here and you're congesting your nose, the device is trying to send the air but it's not getting what you normally use. So what do? You open your mouth to get more air. And then the air doesn't just go to your trachea, you can't regulate it. The air from the siphon goes a little bit, the air that is through the mouth also completes there. But then the air also goes to the esophagus and causes aerophagia. Another reason that can cause aerophagy is when you travel to high altitudes, for example. Imagine that you travel to a place that has high altitude, La Paz, Bolivia, for example. So you're struggling to breathe because of the rarefaction of high altitude. The higher a mountain, the air gets more rough, it gets more rarefaction. So this high altitude, what will happen? You will sleep normally, just like you sleep, but then you start wanting to draw more air. Because that's not enough for you, you have high altitude. So you pull it through your mouth too, and that same situation happens. The air through the mouth, the device delivering a small amount, you trying to breathe through your mouth. The air will pass through the wrong way and will fall into the esophagus. Another issue is when you are breathing, the air is under pressure. And you're trying to throw it out, because the siphon plays a continuous air here. It's always the air going through all the time, so if the air comes in, the air has to come out later. When you breathe out, the air that comes out, it has to have a relief. So the device can have a respiratory relief and this adjustment of the respiratory relief can help. because if you can't throw the air out, it can also cause it to enter the esophagus and cause aerophagia. Another thing, we want to take a look at the mask. So if you are wearing a nasal mask, a mask only on the nose, and you're opening your mouth at night to breathe, because you already have this tendency, you're already used to it. Or if the device is sending a quantity, sometimes less than you need, and you start opening your mouth, all this excess air goes to the stomach, as we already said. So you can use a mouthpiece. What is a mouthpiece? Mouthpiece is like a band, an elastic band that you put on to keep your mouth closed. And then necessarily the air has to enter only through the nose. If you are using a well-adjusted device, the air only through the nose will be enough for you. There will be no air coming through the mouth and there will be less aerophagia. So this mouthpiece you don't always need to use, only when necessary. Sometimes only at the beginning, until you get used to the device. Who is getting a CPAP device? A lot at the beginning, he ends up opening his mouth. The device is not well adjusted, and then sometimes a mouthpiece is ideal for you to get used to the device. Your body gets used to breathing better through the nose with CPAP, and send exclusively the air to the lung. So in some case, in the last case, we can use some other machines. Which are the BPAP? What is BPAP? B is 2, BPAP are 2 pressures, so it will give a greater pressure in the inhale, and a lower pressure when you are doing the inhale. This makes it easier for the air to return, and then you won't need to fight with that single continuous pressure. Against, let's say, against the wind. You will be breathing more easily, and then the air will enter with less quantity to the stomach. But this is in rare cases, in very special cases, which can be used, because it is also a much more expensive device with much more details. But usually adjusting the CPAP device to the ideal pressure. Use a mouthpiece, take care of the respiratory relief of the device. This can help you adapt better to CPAP, it will reduce your aerophagia. And there are other details that if you need it, you are making these adjustments and are not improving. Consult your doctor, sleep doctor or otolaryngologist. That he will guide you, guide details that can change in the configuration of the device. In your care, which can greatly improve aerophagia. So if you like this content about sleep, about CPAP, aerophagia or anything else about otolaryngology, consider subscribing to our channel, activate the bell, we will make a new video every week. And then if you activate the bell, it will recommend it to you. If you liked it, share it with your friends, share it with those you think are using CPAP and need to solve this problem. And if you have any questions about aerophagia and mainly about aerophagia and CPAP, leave your comments, leave your questions, we will try to answer everyone. A hug and see you in the next video.